Hello, my name is Kent.
Today I'd like to describe an adapter I made for a FogBuster that attaches it to an articulating NOGA arm. This is a really useful project because it allows you to quickly reposition your FogBuster after changing tools. For example, this might be a good position for an end mill, while with a drill you may want to reposition the FogBuster so it is shooting the jet of coolant right down into the hole, clearing those chips out, preventing welding onto the flutes. So with that, let's get to it. This is the base that the FogBuster comes with. It has a magnet on the bottom and articulation points that require a hex wrench to adjust. This is where the FogBuster body attaches, and I modeled the NOGA adapter off of this shape. Two big problems with this base is that it does require a wrench to adjust, so you're not adjusting as frequently as you should, so you don't have it in ideal position. And this magnet just plain isn't strong enough to stay on the side of the mill. With the vibrations that are present in the mill, it just works its way down slowly. The NOGA base version solves both of these problems. It's rigidly mounted to the side of the mill, and it's very easy to adjust. Just loosen the NOGA arm, move the mister into position, and tighten it down. Sometimes it's a little awkward to use because these articulation points have a groove in them that will allow the arm to move further, and you have to get those lined up in order to allow that additional movement. But otherwise it's very easy to position for a drill bit, for example, where you want to get it really close and blow those chips out. To adjust the coolant flow, close off the valve completely and then just crack it open. Should be very little coolant that actually flows. I haven't had the arm move under the vibration of the mill. It seems to be very rigid. I mounted the coolant reservoir behind the lathe so I could detach the FogBuster from the mill and take it over the lathe. I thought for the lathe I might be able to use the base that the FogBuster came with. This FogBuster came from Tormach, and an advantage of buying it from them is it came pre-installed with a solenoid. I did have to raise a solenoid in order to use quick disconnects. The coolant that I'm using in the FogBuster is CoolMist. I've had a little bit of discoloration when I've allowed the coolant to sit, especially between the table and the vise. Now I just make a general practice to take the vise off the table at the end of the day and to spray the table and vise down with WD-40. The air line continues from the FogBuster to an air gun that I use to blow chips off. The air compressor that I'm using is from California Air Tools. It's the 10-gallon model, and it's actually quieter than the switch mode power supply for the stepper motors on the mill. The solenoid comes pre-wired with a 120-volt plug. To preserve that plug, I attached it to an extension cord, and then cut the opposite end of the extension cord off and wired it to a solid-state relay. The solenoid requires 120 volts, and to control that, I got a solid-state relay from Automation Direct. That then is controlled on the Pico Universal stepper controller with an additional solid state relay. To turn the mist on manually, and let me see, as simple as selecting mist or flood. They're both mapped to the same device.
This is the design for the adapter. The threaded side mounts into the NOGA arm while the FogBuster mounts onto the straight side. A small groove is made on the FogBuster side so a set screw can set well. Unfortunately, I have no videos of the machining. I held the stock in a 5C collet on the lathe to do all the turning operations. My lathe is not able to thread currently, so I increased the thread relief and used a die. The flats were made on the mill using a 5C indexer. At this point, the adapter has been threaded onto the NOGA arm with a lock washer between the two. The FogBuster has been mounted onto the adapter with the set screw holding the FogBuster in place. A hole was drilled and threaded into the side of the mill's head. Loosen the NOGA arm so that the base can be turned independently with a wrench. Install the bevel washer and then thread and tighten the base onto the mill. Take care drilling and tapping a straight hole and not to over tighten the NOGA thread. The NOGA thread may not be overly strong. I had one snap off with only light tightening. I don't know if one side is better for mounting than the other. I frequently find I wish the FogBuster was on the other side. Mounting it in the front may be a great compromise. Also, while this is a good length for this mill, a longer NOGA arm may give more options. Using this coolant is simple. One only needs an air supply, coolant in the reservoir, and to remember to adjust the aim of the coolant to be on the machined area. I'm using CoolMist, and it does cause a little irritation after hours of use. I was previously using the same coolant with a different mister and had sinus and chest congestion. The worst experience was with an oil mister. The combination of FogBuster and CoolMist is working well. Consumption of coolant is slow. Even 8 hours a day, I bet one could go a couple weeks before refilling. I might experiment with other coolants to find one that I don't react to and does not cause rust on the tools. Until then, I just have to remember to clean up the coolant and spray down surfaces with WD-40. Air is used to clear the chips, and a small amount of coolant is used to cool the tool and workpiece. Too much coolant can cause chips to not be cleared well, and that's the problem that we have here, too much coolant. The coolant can be turned off, leaving the air only, which is nice for cutting absorbent materials. This coolant is worth the cost, and the surface finish does improve. Thank you for watching, and I hope you'll be back for the next video.